animal inside. It's almost pepperoni.
Welcome to Petrolheads London. I'm here with the Audi SQ5, here with its iconic silver S wing mirrors, so you can tell the difference between the cars. Now, I just think for an SUV, this is a pretty damn good looking car. And not only is it good looking, it's a blooming good performer as well. And it doesn't behave like a big hefty SUV like you'd expect a lot of them to. This behaves like a sports car, and it's as quick as a sports car as well.
Holy cow, this thing is so quick. It really is. If I make a comparison on this between the F-Type, so I think the F-Type's 0-60 is 4.9 seconds. This is 5.1, and it's an SUV. I mean, this thing must weigh twice as much, at least, let me just put it to normal mode, than the F-Type. But my word, if you want to give it some stick, it goes. And it sticks to the road as well. 3-litre V6 bi-turbo. So what does that mean? Well, in real terms, it means it's still a diesel, but it's a bloody quick diesel. It's really quick. And it's really got the torque that you need for a car like this, especially a big, weighty car like this. You put your foot down on the kickdown and it goes. As I've already shown you, put it into the sports mode by yanking the gear knob back and putting it in sport mode or putting it into dynamic mode. It really is quite a good car, and especially for an SUV. What the 3-litre V6 bi-turbo does give you is a relatively fuel-efficient car. Now, for roads like this and, you know, dual carriageways, it's giving you probably mid-30s. On the higher end, when you're sort of cruising on motorways, taking it easy in comfort mode and not having to hang around in much traffic, you're probably getting in the 40s. I think it's booked at average of around 40, 45. So it's relatively usable as an everyday car as well. You know, it's not something that's going to really chew through the miles, especially with diesel going up. I know there's a lot of debate around whether diesels are the right way to go or not, but for me, this is, I think, a good car. In terms of driving it, as I said, I think the only criticism I've got is when you're on the motorways, and I've been doing a lot of motorway work in this car, where there's restricted limits and very, very narrow lanes. And when you've got it in like a comfort mode, the steering wheel feels like there's a little bit of play in it. So you feel like you're constantly making minor corrections. You don't notice that as much in wider lanes, sort of faster flowing traffic like this. So a minor gripe, I think, you know, along with, as I said, maybe some of the little finish things, but it is really, really well put together as a car. My initial impressions around this car, I've been living with it for a while now, are it just drives incredibly well. On a motorway, it's super smooth. So you've got a set of modes that you can select. So it's called Drive Select, and you can select it into individual, efficiency, comfort, and auto, and then dynamic, which as well. It's got relatively low profile tyres on it, so bugger all good for off-roading probably, but it is 4x4, it's got the Quattro system on it. It's this kind of like Jekyll and Hyde, and I know I kind of used this a bit with the F-Type, actually, thinking back to one of my very first videos, and it's just so usable as an SUV, and we have a dog, so hence the dog grill in the back. So it's got a huge boot that we can partition off to put the dog in and all our stuff. There's plenty of space for three people and the three adults in the back, lots of leg room, really comfortable. And up front, it's a joy to be in as well. Now, my benchmark has always been my C63 AMG, because without a shadow of a doubt, is the best built car I have ever owned. This doesn't quite get there, but it's not far off. It really is good. There's a few bits, and you know, if you watch some of my other videos, it's probably one of my pet hates. It's just bits of finish. So little bits of the dasher could be a bit nicer, and the door pockets as well are plastic. And I know that's where they save some money. This is a much cheaper car than something like, say, a Range Rover Sport, which was kind of in the running for this type of car, but it just sounds phenomenal. You've got an exhaust valve on it. So on the individual mode that I mentioned, you can set up these three elements. So it's the engine, the steering, the suspension, and the exhaust. And so I have the exhaust in dynamic, which basically opens the valve. It's super comfortable on motorways, soaks up the bumps, even though it's got 21-inch low profile wheels. It just just a really comfortable ride. And you know, obviously I'm a little bit biased about why I like this car, but when I look at this at value for money wise versus a Range Rover Sport, this has got everything that that has. This comes with oodles of feature. This particular one has a panoramic sunroof, and if you've watched my videos, you know I'm a big fan of panoramic sunroofs. I think that makes a real difference. It's so nice to be able to open that up in the summer. Not that I've had much chance to do that. But also just letting a bit of light into the car. It's also got a sort of a netting that pulls over it electronically as well. Heated seats, full infotainment system, full parking sensors, reverse camera. It's got everything. Power tailgate. Oh, that's the only thing is, on my C63, I had the estate version. You could open the tailgate, as you can from this one, by a button down here. You can't close it though, so you still have to get out. And I know that feels a bit lazy, but there are times where somebody's just grabbed something out and you want to close it as they walk off because they might not know where the button is, or they're just not familiar with the car. As I said, little things really. Sound system, which is absolutely fantastic. The only thing I say is it's got a pretty measly sub that sits in the boot in kind of well where you would have a spare wheel if you went for that option. I've disconnected it because frankly I think it just pisses my dog off and it's a bit unfair on him having that thumping away underneath, and I don't think you really need it. It pretty much fills in the sound anyway with the speakers around, loads in the dash. And
so I've jumped back in the car, and one of the things I haven't talked about, although I've mentioned a lot about the interior and the things I normally do, like panoramic sunroof and infotainment and all that kind of good stuff, which you expect in a car of this level. Talking about seats as well, so we have the sports seats in these, the S-Line sports seats, and they're super comfy, and so often you get in sports seats and you know what, they're a bit uncomfortable, you have to sort of, you know, adjust so many things to get them right, but this has like adjustable lumbar, fully electric except for the backwards and forwards, I think is a bar. You can adjust the width of the bottom of the seat or the length of it, so make it, you know, there's a piece that pulls out from under here. You know, I can't fault the spec on these cars. They are truly, truly brilliant. Big 21 inch diamond cut alloys, which are gorgeous, and so I'm hoping I won't ever cause any damage to them, but I do have my alloy gaiters on, see video down here, to see what that's like. But it performs really well even with them. Even though they're these big wheels with low profile tyres, you don't feel every inch and bump, it glides across the road. And as I said, it's a real mile muncher. And I've really enjoyed driving this car, motorways, country lanes. It kind of turns its hands to everything. Yes, it's not a sports car, and yes, it's not a supercar. You know, it's never gonna be in that league, but it's blooming practical. And it kind of does what it says on the tin. The thing I like about it is it's a bit different to the normal SUV. Okay, it's in a different type of league to something like, say, a Range Rover Sport. But I think this is a really good contender when looking at these kind of cars. And how does it compare to the F-Pace? Well, that's an interesting one because I actually think this is probably better. But this is a higher performance version than the F-Pace I tried. If I'd liked the F-Pace that much, then maybe that's what we would have got. But it's a good car, this. It really is a good car. And I think even the base models are quite good. The 2-litre TFSI has got a fantastic engine in it, and I think even on a big car like this, performs quite well. But this, the performance is outstanding. Anyway, thank you for watching Petrolheads London. Please remember to like and subscribe. Cheers.